Church service started this evening, and the priest said our goal as Christians and what we know we have in store for us is to what? Be victorious over death. Be victorious over death. And I thought about that, and I said, hey, folks, it's very easy, actually. In fact, you're not necessarily victorious over it. So you want to hear about it? I'll tell you about it. You simply realize that you don't need death. You don't need death. And this is the same for sickness. I don't need sickness. I don't need death. I don't need sickness. I don't need a body. I don't need a world. I don't need form. I don't need time. I don't need space. I don't need death. I don't need sickness. I don't need a body. I don't need a world. I don't need a form. I don't need time. I don't need space. You overcome all of this by recognizing you don't need it. You don't need it. So can we be free of death? Absolutely, of course, and we all will. And it's very simple and very easy. You just recognize you don't need it. Duality, how do you get enlightened? You recognize you don't need it. You don't need duality. You don't need delusion. You don't need any troubles. That's how you are free of them, by realizing you don't need them. Now, this is a huge insight, and it's it's obvious, it's simple. So, went home, prepared dinner, ate dinner, and then I said, I'll come out here and tape. There's no big hurry, no big rush on it. It's not going anywhere. The insight's not going anywhere. It wasn't some flash of illumination. I just said, oh yeah, it's obvious. This is where we're at now. So this is where we're at. And it's a good place to be at, that is for sure. We don't need death. We simply don't need death. Now, how do we get here? Well, the previous videos have pointed that out. I try to make a very, very, very full of intense clarification and insight. I know it's a lot of hours, so it's hard for everyone to get to all those videos, but it's in there, it's all in there. And maybe we won't clutter this video up with trying to go back over all that information. Who triumphs? No one triumphs over death. Spirit simply realizes it doesn't need death. It doesn't need death. In fact, Spirit realizes it's never needed death. And in fact, Spirit realizes it's never died at all. And if Spirit hasn't died, what is death then? Nothing. So not only has Spirit never died, isn't dying now, won't die now, has never died, can never die. This is the realization that Spirit has. Spirit can never die. It's impossible. And Spirit realizes it doesn't need to. Doesn't need to, and then it all becomes clear. Spirit just invented these devices and this notion that these devices equal death, dying. What does dying mean? It means a transition into oblivion is what Spirit invented all this for. Imagine it all. A transition into oblivion. There is no oblivion. Spirit doesn't need to find oblivion. Once Spirit realizes it doesn't need to find oblivion, it certainly doesn't need death anymore. It doesn't need sickness anymore. It doesn't need a body anymore. It doesn't need aging. It doesn't even need a body. It doesn't need form. It doesn't need a world. It doesn't need time, space. All that, it was just imagined by Spirit as a hopeful way, a hopeful, plausible scenario of how to find oblivion. How to find oblivion. How to reach oblivion. And when Spirit realized it doesn't need to reach oblivion, it'll see there is none. There is no oblivion. There was never any. Nothing ever happened. Nothing ever died. Nothing was ever born. Nothing ever died. It's all imagination, all a dream. Why is spirit trying to find oblivion? Because it tried to define reality, which automatically gives rise to this experiencing of definitional chaos, because you cannot put any definition whatsoever on reality. And the attempt to do so, not being able to place it anywhere, it seems this definition is just completely chaotic. A definition of complete chaos, and you can't stand that. So you automatically have this desire just for oblivion. Just, even though it's stupid, because if there's an oblivion, you wouldn't know that you're being freed from this horrible chaoticness. But spirit doesn't worry about that obvious contradiction there. It just says, I just want oblivion, can you know, get me away from this. And so then it imagines a hopeful means to reach oblivion, which is time, space, worlds, bodies, time, space, form, worlds, bodies, sickness, aging, death. And then when spirit realizes, hey, reality can't be defined, so I'm just going to stop trying. No more chaotic definition. Definitional chaos. No more definitional chaos. Nothing but peace. Perfect peace and serenity. No more need for time, space, form, worlds, bodies, aging, sickness, death. No more need for any of that. No more need for it. No more need. The word need is very important. Spirit doesn't need any of that. In fact, the spirit doesn't need anything. No such thing as needs. Spirit doesn't have needs. Spirit doesn't have needs. Reality doesn't have needs. It's perfectly free to, for all experiencing. There's no need for any particular experiencing at all. So it's very simple. Now, how could it be any simpler, actually? You say, oh yeah, don't need death, don't need it. You don't need it, you don't need it. The reason why we seem to have bodies, form, bodies, time, space, world, aging, sickness, death, is because we believe we need it. We believe we need it in order. We think this is the way to oblivion. And that protects us. It gets rid of, it seems to be safety from definitional chaos. Now, keeping this simple, seeing the simplicity of it is where it's all at. That's where it's all at. You're not going to find that very many places. So, we're not used to it. We just, a priori, we reject any simple explanation like this. But this is the explanation. Need look no further. So, yeah. Just let it sink in. You have to give it time to sink in. And realize you don't have to react. You can just let it sink in. Just say, yeah, I get it. Easy. I don't need any of that. Now, I can have it. I don't need it. But I can maintain a body. That's no problem. I don't need to. But I can choose to. You can even choose to have the body die if you want to. You don't need to. Don't need to at all. So this is the gospel. This is the good news. Now, Jesus could not have been resurrected. He had to die first to show people in a dramatic way. You don't need to die. You don't need to die. And you could even raise the body up after it's dead when you realize you don't need to die. And he said, ah, it's not possible. What are you talking about? Now, sickness, healing sickness, all you do is, if someone gets well, they just simply realize they don't need to be sick. That's it. All the complexity is not, it's not needed at all. I don't need to be sick. I don't need this sickness. I don't need it. Now, they may not let go of death or other sicknesses. They just may say, well, I really don't need this sickness. I just feel like I don't need it. And then maybe another one will come along. They say, well, maybe I need that one. But all, really, you don't need any sickness. You don't need any pathway to oblivion at all. You don't need any evidence or hope for oblivion. So sickness is just hope for oblivion. Don't need that. Don't need that. It's all equally. All equally don't need it. There's no reason to make distinctions whatsoever among any kind of illness at all. None. Just simply you don't need it. It's that simple. One panacea for all ills. Don't need it. One simple panacea for all ills. I don't need it. Nobody needs it. No one needs oblivion. There is no oblivion anyway. But no one needs to have hope to find it either. Today, August 17th, yeah. Well, that's a good day to recognize this. It's a good day to recognize this. This is the time. This time of August is always a great time for me. And this recognition, the complete simplicity of it all, is a great recognition. I'm very happy for my teacher, you know, very happy for my root teacher and all teachers. And hopefully they're happy for me. Say, hey, you know, student is doing well. It's doing well. No order of degree of difficulty in miracles whatsoever. Just realize you don't need it. Plain and simple. Yeah, people can get well. If they just forget that they need it, they just kind of, you know, just no longer think they need it, and before you know it, it's just, it's gone. So these are great milestones to pass. Keep this video simple. Try to keep it simple. Just let this settle in. It's super significant. Super significant. But maintain your discipline of quiet, still sitting. This helps. It helps a lot. Because you know no matter what insight you have, you can maintain this still, quiet sitting, humble, quiet sitting. I mean, you just realize that, you know, that the key to all healing everything and happiness, to freeing free from death, sickness, aging, even the body, all form, all unhappiness, just don't need it. Just realize that, but just stay sitting calmly and quietly, committed to that. So it doesn't matter what insight arises, you're committed to not acting anything out in any way. You're going to continue sitting quietly. This is the key. This is the key. Like, I was in church when I got it, and of course you're committed there to sitting quietly, right? It's very helpful, church, actually. You're committed for an hour just to sit quietly. Most of the time just sitting in there. You can't act anything out. You can't raise your hands. Hey, I just realized how to get free of death and all sickness. You can't do that. Nobody cares. And so you just, oh, okay. You just keep sitting quietly. So the discipline of sitting quietly is an awesome ally. Awesome ally. Because you'll gain confidence. You'll say, hey, I can have any insight at all. And I'm going to remain sitting quietly. So I can even recognize how to be free of death and sickness, aging, all suffering. I can realize how to do that. Simple. Just realize I don't need it. I just keep sitting quietly. Undisturbed. No big deal. So the insights will arise when you have the discipline to not act upon them in any way. Let it sink in. Let the continuity problem work itself out. Silent sitting is one of the secrets for sure. Committed to not interpret or act out or act upon anything, just going to continue to keep sitting here. So I could see the answer to everything, which is, yeah, suffering, we don't need it. That is the answer to all problems. We don't need them. And yeah, continue quietly here like this. So, whenever possible, as much as possible, be committed. Make the commitment. I'm going to sit here like a stone, no matter what happens. I'm going to sit here like a stone, no matter what happens. And you will find that the truth seems to reveal itself to you. It's just there, you see. You notice it. Say, oh, I see the answer. It's right here. Now, you don't hear very often someone say, Our goal and what we're going to reach for sure is freedom from death. That's what they say, you know, that's what the priest said before the Mass. It's like, wow, that's pretty cool, isn't it? For someone, people to hear this, that, hey, we know we are going to be freed of death. We're going to be victorious over death. We are going to be victorious over death. And you say, that's very nice to say that. So let me add a little something. Let me respond to you. So I felt, hey, if people are willing to listen to that, you know, why not bring up how to actually do that? Yeah, don't need it. Don't need that. Yeah, most talk is like how can we be, you know, a little happier in the world, and how can we, you know, be a little more charitable, and how can we try and, you know, do more research on illnesses, and how can we have a fulfilling life? And no, the priest said, hey, we're going to be victorious over death. That's our goal. That's what we're going to reach here. That's why we're here. That's why we're ultimately here, is to be victorious over death. And I would just say, you don't have to be victory over. Simply don't need it. Since you don't need it, it doesn't hang around. It's only hanging around because you think you need it, because you believe you need it. You don't need it, gone. It's just an interpretation anyway. And a desire to have evidence to suggest such an interpretation. Yeah. Just an appearance. So I'll sleep on this tonight, just sleep on it. See how we feel in the morning. Is it correct? Yeah, absolutely it's correct. But is anybody going to believe it? Well, maybe not. That's okay. But the continuity fear gets in the way, so I understand that. So I don't have to like run out and tell everybody, and everybody's gonna say, oh my gosh. We've been waiting for that. It's not like some pill. You say, hey, folks, we got the pill. Cures cancer. Everybody be running to the store, right? Get that out right away. We got to have that. Here, you tell people, you know, you're free of death because you don't need it. Sickness, all suffering, you don't need it. That's it. That's all you need to know. And yeah, no interest. But see, that cannot phase you from actually recognizing it. That's the tough thing in this world. This situation, whatever you want to call it, is that the truth is just obvious and simple, but nobody wants it. And the collective will is so strong that they don't want it because they think they do need it. That it's very difficult here to recognize the truth and accept it. It's very difficult. No matter how simple it is, if everybody just says there's absolutely no value whatsoever in recognizing this, we need all this stuff. Well, it's tough to then even focus on it, because everybody overlooks it. If everyone's overlooking it, you think maybe it's not there, or maybe it's not important. It's not there. It's not important. Nobody cares. We'll see who cares. I recognize today how to sing, and that's something that people would care more about than how to be. Realize you don't need death, suffering, sickness, misery, aging. Don't need any of that at all. Incarnation, bodies, you don't need anything. People would rather know how to sing well than this, for sure. And, you know, today in church I did practice a technique that I come across just last week. Just sort of tried something. I said, whoa, that's easy. Then I last week I went to church and I sang really well, trying it, but I sang too loud, so I toned it down today, and I'm more under control. And it was just effortless, just beautiful, smooth, resonant, just fantastic singing. It's just a simple little technique, actually. But people be way more interested in that than finding out that, hey, we don't need death, we don't need suffering, we don't need sickness, we don't need it. That's how you get free of it. Virtually no interest whatsoever in this world. That's a fact. That's pretty funny. And yet everybody's complaining about suffering. They complain about suffering, but they still hold on to it desperately. Because it represents hope for oblivion. This whole situation is built on the premise that definitional chaos is a given, that this is what reality is turned into, which is a false premise. It's a false premise. We're simply trying to pin a definition on it and finding out we can't. That's all. It doesn't mean reality has turned into some chaos. It doesn't mean that at all. People say, well, yeah, but how did you sing good? How did you... It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. It really matter. But people think that they're more saved if they can sing really well than if they realize they don't need suffering, you know? It just doesn't equate. So, yeah, you can realize this and realize you don't need any of it, and be truly realized and all that in this world. And almost nobody will, or almost everyone will pass you by. Not even important. You get up there and belt out your singing. Just belt it out. Everybody will beat it past your door. You know, they'll treat you like a god or a goddess. And sell out all your concerts. People say you're just like, wow, this is just the best. You know, and completely ignore the one who knows now that don't need death, don't need suffering, don't need a body, don't need form, world, time, space, don't need any of it. So very, very, very funny juxtaposition. Realize how to sing well after all these years of trying, and how to be free of death. Realize that at the same time. Yeah, you get a million students if you teach them how to sing. And if you teach them, don't need death, you know. Wow, maybe nobody. Now that's funny. See, this is funny. This is humor. This is the humor that I appreciate. This really is quite amazingly funny. I don't find comedians very funny in this world, to tell the truth. It's fear-based. It's all fear-based. I just have a different sense of humor. It's hey, we can act like animals. Hey, that's funny, isn't it? That's really funny. It's not really funny. It's a good way to waste some time, though. But I find just the incredible cosmic humor of just everybody insisted, oh, gosh, I'm suffering so bad. This is life so tough. And then you give them the answer. And I want to know how to sing well. You can tell me how to sing well. So you have to have a high sense of humor, a really good sense of humor as you work on this, because the absurdity is so extreme, just such incredibly funny absurdities. You have to laugh at it, otherwise you'll tear your hair out. Just what? You know, what? It's just to see it as like cosmic humor. Somebody complains that they're impoverished, so impoverished. And you say, here's $1 billion for you. And they see a penny and they say, wow, look at that penny. Give me that penny. They say, but I got $1 billion. Ah, don't bother me, I'm going after that penny. You have to laugh. You're screaming, help, 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 help. Then you have the answer, not interested in that. Help, 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 help. What they say, help, 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 they want oblivion. They say, we're suffering so terrible. Can you just give us oblivion? Please, please. Oh. See, all the suffering is the price they're paying. They think they can purchase oblivion through all the misery and suffering. You can't purchase what doesn't exist. That's another funny thing. Trying to purchase what doesn't exist. They're totally obsessed with that. You know, what's the price? I mean, how do I purchase it? How do I, I'm trying trying to get, you know, enough money, or, you know, what's the right way to purchase this oblivion? Doesn't exist. Oh, they're not interested in that. No, I'm interested in how to purchase it. Maybe if I sing well, will that give me oblivion when I die? The death of a singer. The death of a great singer. Everybody pays attention. The death of a great entertainer, great singer. Say, maybe they reached oblivion. Wow. That's possible, huh? Sure, everyone's suffering here. But just because you come into this world and answer their suffering doesn't mean they want the answer you have. They want to get free of suffering through oblivion, which is impossible. They don't want to get free of suffering through realizing suffering's not necessary. That's the last thing on their mind, and it never has even crossed their mind, actually, here. It never crosses hardly anyone's mind here at all. That's how you do it. You just realize you don't need it. It just does not come across anyone's mind here. So you just assume that everybody's suffering, that they would, obviously, you wouldn't overlook anything so completely obvious, would they? So you just don't even think, well, I better not even say it or look there, it's just, right? But they are overlooking it entirely, because they're convinced that oblivion's the answer. Trying to structure as much as possible. Also, thinking like, we just structure everything. Maybe that'll be a defense against it. But ultimately, oblivion is the real answer, they think. They do the structuring to buy them time until they can find oblivion, is what it is. All this structuring is buying time until they can finally find the purchase price of oblivion. This is funny stuff. It really is. Have to laugh at it. Always keep a sense of humor when you're working on these intense root issues. Have to. Otherwise you'll get so frustrated. So this is true for everyone, Gentile or Jew, you know, so to speak. Everybody don't need it. No one needs it. It's not just true for some, it's true for all. It's true for all. It's true for all. There is no chaos in reality whatsoever. Therefore, there's no need to try and find oblivion, and there is no oblivion. There's no way to take even the first step towards it. How can we take the first step towards what doesn't exist? How can we get closer to what doesn't exist? See, this whole relativity dualistic belief system we have is, instead of saying, well, we're getting closer to oblivion, we say, well, I'm farther away from that than I was before. So that means I must be closer to my goal. See, that we play this game of duality, of contrast, of bigger, smaller, greater, lesser. And then, so it seems like we're making progress, right, within that. But that's irrelevant, because the purpose of all this is to reach oblivion. And there is no oblivion. So we're actually not going anywhere towards it, ever. So to hide this from ourselves, we preoccupied with, well, I'm going down this road, and back there it's farther away from me, and now I'm going towards that, I'm getting closer to that, you see, and it's like that. But keep in mind, in pure spaciousness, which we're all abiding in, how can we get closer or farther away to pure spaciousness? How can we be going away from pure spaciousness, or going towards it? And that's what really matters. So is there any distancing in pure spaciousness between anything in relative to pure spaciousness? No. You're all 100% right there, right now. All here-ness is all here-ness. You don't change here-ness. Light went on. Don't change here-ness by going anywhere. As I say, we're always exactly where we've always been. Which is, there is no oblivion. We've never taken the first step towards it. We never can. We never can. We can't advance towards what doesn't exist. The fact that something is farther behind you doesn't mean it has any oblivion to it, does it? The fact that you drive from one city to the next, you can't see the city you left. You're so far behind me. Does that mean that's oblivion? Well, we interpret it as progress towards oblivion. See, there's evidence right there. See, sensory perception fools us. It's not, the city that we left is not in oblivion to pure spaciousness, is it? With the ground of being, isn't it 100% abiding in pure spaciousness? Just like the road is, just like the other city what you're driving to, it's all exactly 100% here in pure spaciousness. Nothing's happened at all. There's no oblivion happening to anything based on traveling time, space. But we'll leave that for another time. We don't need to worry too much about that. We're just hanging out here with the realization that don't need to die, don't need death. Don't need any of this. We can keep it for a while, but we don't need to, but we can. Nothing says we cannot. Just enjoy it. Just enjoy it. It doesn't have any purpose other than just enjoyment. No purpose at all. So this insight is so intense, I can feel that if I try to explain too much, I start getting not feeling so good. I say, whoa, wait a minute, let's not do too much here. Let's not bite off more than we can chew. This is not the time or place to do a whole bunch of explanations. I just keep it to the basics here. Don't need fatigue. Don't need it. That too is seems like plausible hope for oblivion. I'm slipping into oblivion. I'm slipping into sleep. Don't even need sleep, do we? Slipping into oblivion. Don't need the problems that seem to bring us stress, to push us into oblivion. Don't need any troubles at all, actually. Don't need to symbolize the hope for oblivion in any way. I just simply don't need it. Don't need it. You see, that's obvious. So you hang out with the clarity. You hang out with it. You honor it, you give it its time, you don't rush away from it. Let it sit, settle in. It's like somebody has a, $400. The kid guests just don't, like, gulp it down. Okay, gotta go. Thanks, man. Gone. That's not the purpose. The purpose is, hey, take your time with it. After you're finished, honor it, settle. Let it settle in. Let's hang around for a while. That's what the expensive bottle of wine is saying to some people. You know, just let's hang around together for a while. Let's not be in a hurry. So when we see an insight so important as we've had tonight in this video, whenever you're watching it, just hang around for a while. Don't be in a hurry to leave. You don't go, oh yeah, I don't need to die, don't need to be sick, don't need to age, don't even need a body. Okay, great, okay, gotta go. Got it, all right. Lots of other stuff to do. And you may think that there's all these bells and whistles going off. Say, this is incredible. This is no, nothing's really happening. Now just see how it goes. You never know how these insights and clarity plays out. You just don't know. That's been my experience in life. It just never seems to be the way you think. Every time I think I've done a great job and I'm going to get a really great night's sleep and have some wonderful dreams, you always have a terrible night after that. So it's better to maybe just have no expectations at all. I have no expectations. Just let it settle in. Let the continuity fear evaporate. And it evaporates kind of slowly, too. You don't be in a hurry. Just let it evaporate. It's like boiling a pan of water until it's all evaporated. You know, it takes a while. But you got the pan on the stove and the heat, the flame's on it. Just wait. It'll happen. Just wait. Just hang out. Eventually you'll look and all the water is boiled away. Now, if this is true, it'll be true today, it'll be true tomorrow, it'll be true every day. I don't need to run in there, hey folks, type it up on the website, hey, this is how you be free of death, you know. It'll be true tomorrow as well. And it's like if you're waking up and you're still very drowsy, you don't feel like waking up all the way, right, when you're drowsy. It's only when you finally reach a point you say, wow, I don't think I can go back to sleep at all. This is what happened to me yesterday. I realized I can't not be realized now. I cannot not reach realization or be realized, recognize the truth. I cannot not recognize the truth now. It's too late for that. It's like you reach a point when you're waking up from sleep and you say, you know what, there's no way I can go back to sleep. It's just not going to work for me. So, might as well get up. It's like that. So when you reach that point, then you say, hey, I might as well realize I don't need death. That's what allows it to go. Don't need it. Might as well get all this stuff now. There's no point. I can't go back to sleep anyway. How can I go back to sleep? How can anyone go back to sleep when they recognize this is the question. But if you want to go back to sleep, then you might not want to recognize it because it'll kind of disturb your sleep. You say, hey, wait a minute. There's something I'm missing here as I'm sleeping. I don't think I'm getting what I need here, really want when I'm sleeping. And then the sort of twilight half drowsiness, you might say, I kind of want it, but I kind of don't. Wishy-washy about it. And you just think, wow, I should really be able to get this, but I just like feel so ambivalent about it. You know, that's what happens, right? It takes a while until you get to the point where you really realize I can't go back to sleep. It's not possible. So then bring the hammer down. Say, okay, hammer time. It's hammer time. That's what I call hammer time. Once you realize you can't not recognize the truth, you can't not recognize, it's too late for that. That's hammer time. And that's bringing the hammer down. And I said, might as well just get it all out of the way right now. It's time to wake up. Let's just do it right now. Bring the hammer down on that. You know, the nail is so close to being all the way in, you might as well just bring the hammer down and just drive it all the way in. Just finish it. One blow, boom, finished. None of this tap, 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 tap. You keep tapping a nail out. Is it going to go in? Well, a tiny little bit, tap, 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 tap. You get it in enough, and then you realize, wow, I don't think I'm going to be pulling this nail out. I think it's in. Then you say, hey, hammer time, wham, finished. Now, all dispute about gradual enlightenment, sudden enlightenment, is both. Is both. That's the answer to it. Or, I don't know, dispute, shop talk, whatever. However you want to call it, all the shop talk. Is it so gradual or is it sudden? It's gradual and then it's sudden. There's tapping time, tap, 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 and then there's hammer time. Tapping time and hammer time. It's hammer time right now, for me especially, but in the world, it's hammer time. You can't afford to tap, 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 tap. Right now, you got to say, let me bring the hammer as much as I can. Let me just try. Got to try. Otherwise, oh boy. Off in more mad pursuits of oblivion. That's not going to be any fun at all. Of course, everybody will think it is. Aren't we having fun, folks? Oh, yeah, we're really having fun. Aren't we? Aren't we? Oh, yeah, aren't we? Everyone says, yeah, aren't we? Yeah, aren't we? Yeah, yeah. I think we are, aren't we? I hope we are. I hope we're having fun. I hope we're having fun. I hope we're getting there. I hope so. No, we're not. Not getting anywhere. You know, it would be cool is to get some rain in California. That's what would be cool. We talk about coolness. I mean, that's something we're gonna. I'd come out of the house and I mean, that's something I want to see. I just hear some sprinklers on somewhere. It's like, oh, that sounds nice. Just to hear the soft, gentle, you know, rain hitting all the leaves, and just the sound of rain, the coolness of rain. Yeah, rain is, you miss rain when it doesn't rain at all. You miss it. Get too much of it, you hate it. Oh, I don't want to see it. But when none, you don't have any for so long, you say, wow, I really like to see some nice rain. The freshness it brings, the smells it brings, right? Just everything is dust washed off, everything's shining and glistening, and it's like a renewal or refreshment. It's very nice, and we haven't had anything here, and nothing in the foreseeable future. You know, it's just amazing. You think of all the people here, we collectively say, hey, we need some rain, have a rain, but maybe this is just another, you know, push towards oblivion. California is going towards oblivion. Living here, you feel like you're going towards oblivion, actually. No matter how nice it is, it's a tick-tock, the clock is ticking, you know, it's like, wow. We're slowly marching into oblivion, the state. How is that possible? You know, well, if no rain this year, we get another drought winter, and then it goes a whole nother year to another December, you know, it's going to be like oblivion here. In a lot of ways, sure. Yeah, absolutely. People will start feeling like we're getting real close to oblivion, so that's the golden state for you. Maybe we should all say, forget it, let it rain. Let's have the rain. Let the rain come down. All right. Very great. So we just hung out here for a while. And just another day in the life. And we just realize, oh yeah, we don't need death, don't need aging, sickness, body, everything's fine. Don't need unhappiness, don't need fear, don't need form, don't need any troubles, no concerns, don't need any of that. Okay, great, great, great. And so, have a good rest of the day, and I will do something, and then I'll sleep on it. It's that simple. That simple. All right. Thanks for watching. See you next time. That's it.